Last week, I got an email that I almost overlooked. It said, "Dear Life Noggin, can very bad things be good for you? Signed, Tim O." I almost disregarded the question because, well, avoiding dangerous elements like radiation or toxins seems like a no-brainer. Those things could cause some serious damage or even kill ya. But according to one theory, it's not as black and white as it seems. The real danger comes from the dose, and in some cases, if you are given a small enough amount of something that's typically considered harmful, you may instead see some health benefits. One second, I'm just getting a note from the Life Noggin lawyers. Do not try ingesting or purposely doing anything that can cause you harm or kill you. We are not saying to do any of this. Consult a doctor, don't hurt yourself. Also, Blocko is really cool and smart and buff. Agreed to all of that. So, could bad things potentially help you? Cue the intro. This is the theory of hormesis. It's been around for quite some time, with the concept originating from the 16th century. Since then, scientists have identified a variety of stressors that can cause an adverse reaction at high doses, but a beneficial one at low doses. These include things like exercise, dieting, heat, various chemicals like toxins, restricting blood flow, and even radiation. While each works in a slightly different way, in general, they cause mild stress on the cells by producing free radicals, moving molecules in or out of our cells, and increasing the demand for energy. In response, protective, stress-resistant proteins are made, like antioxidants. For example, exercise puts a lot of stress on your cells, like starving them of oxygen and depressing the immune system. But the cells adapt and develop a more efficient defense system. However, if you exercise too hard or often, it can cause overuse injuries and decrease your immune system. There are a number of other possible stressors currently being evaluated for medical applications. The most widely studied is ischemic preconditioning. This is when blood flow to a certain organ or tissue is restricted for a short period of time. Some evidence suggests that this will allow the body to build up a tolerance to it before it occurs naturally and causes a serious injury to an organ like the heart or brain. But so far, clinical studies have had mixed results, and the mechanism is still poorly understood. Radiation has had a similar outcome. Some cellular studies have found that low doses of radiation can create a positive effect, with one rodent study resulting in a delay of the onset of cancer. But others have found that there is no effect, or that it prevented DNA repair. So yeah, there's a lot to still figure out there. Clearly, a lot of work still needs to be done to fully understand this process and determine whether or not it can be applied medically. I definitely don't want to be the test subject for any of these, though. Just putting that out there. So maybe for now the saying should go, what doesn't kill you might make you stronger. So what's one bad thing you still cling to? I consume too many pizza bagels, but what's your vice? Let me know in the comment section below, only if you feel comfortable doing so. Also, click like and subscribe because it really helps this channel grow. Thanks. Click here to watch this video we did on the secrets hidden in your DNA, or click here to watch this video. Thanks to Lifespan, the team that powers Life Noggin. Check out the great work they do down in the description. And as always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.